Mahasaraswati is the mother's power of work and her spirit of perfection and order. The youngest of the four, she is the most skillful in executive faculty and the nearest to physical nature. Maheshwari lays down the large lines of the world forces. Mahakali drives their energy and impetus. Mahalakshmi discovers their rhythms and measures. But Mahasaraswati presides over their detail of organization and execution, relation of parts and effective combination of forces and unfailing exactitude of result and fulfillment. The science and craft and technique of things are Mahasaraswati's province. Always she holds in her nature and can give to those whom she has chosen the intimate and precise knowledge, the subtlety and patience, the accuracy and intuitive mind and conscious hand and discerning eye of the perfect worker. This power is the strong, the tireless, the careful and efficient builder, organizer, administrator, technician, artisan and classifier of the worlds. When she takes up the transformation and new building of the nature, her action is laborious and minute, and often seems to our impatience slow and interminable, but it is persistent, integral, and flawless. For the will in her works is scrupulous, unsleeping, indefatigable. Leaning over us, she notes and touches every little detail, finds out every minute defect, gap, twist, or incompleteness, considers and weighs accurately all that has been done and all that remains still to be done hereafter. Nothing is too small or apparently trivial for her attention. Nothing, however impalpable or disguised or latent, can escape her. Molding and remolding, she labors each part till it has attained its true form, is put in the exact place in the whole and fulfills its precise purpose. In her constant and diligent arrangement and rearrangement of things, her eye is on all needs at once and the way to meet them, and her intuition knows what is to be chosen and what rejected, and successfully determines the right instrument, the right time, the right conditions, and the right process. Carelessness and negligence and indolence she abhors. All scamped and hasty and shuffling work, all clumsiness and à peu près and misfire, all false adaptation and misuse of instruments and faculties, and leaving of things undone or half done, is offensive and foreign to her temper. When her work is finished, nothing has been forgotten, no part has been misplaced or omitted or left in a faulty condition. All is solid, accurate, complete, admirable. Nothing short of a perfect perfection satisfies her, and she is ready to face an eternity of toil, if that is needed, for the fullness of her creation. Therefore, of all the mother's power, she is the most long-suffering with man and his thousand imperfections. Kind, smiling, close, and helpful, not easily turned away or discouraged, insistent, even after repeated failure, her hand sustains our every step on condition that we are single in our will and straightforward and sincere. For a double mind she will not tolerate, and her revealing irony is merciless to drama and histrionics and self-deceit and pretense. A mother to our wants, a friend in our difficulties, a persistent and tranquil counselor and mentor, chasing away with her radiant smile the clouds of gloom and fretfulness and depression, reminding always of the ever-present help, pointing to the eternal sunshine. She is firm, quiet, and persevering in the deep and continuous urge that drives us towards the integrality of the higher nature. All the work of the other powers leans on her for its completeness, for she assures the material foundation, elaborates the stuff of detail, and erects and rivets the armor of the structure.